Okay. Let's get back into it. Some of you might be happy to know that I have made no progress on that monologue I was complaining about. If you were around for that. Or seen it. Hopefully no, as few people see that, the better. But regardless, I can't decide if I'm going to continue thumbnailing the action sequence. Or if I'm just going to pick a page that I've already started a thumbnail from it. And just start fleshing it out and such. So we can bring that up. Here it is. Am I levitating over there? No, that's just a little box around the name. So I'm hesitating. I might choose this page here and just decide to roll with it. I have more thumbnails I could choose from, I think. Where yet? These ones? Yeah, I got a couple. So we got a few. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This would be a fun page to do, I think. I'm trying to remember what I would have put for the words. I think I remember. I'm just going to write down some keywords so that I remember what the heck I was even trying to put here. Whoops. Really should have wrote this down. I was like messing around with dialogue, but not actually committing to a note file what it would have said here, which is the number one mistake. If you ever think you're gonna remember something later, don't trust yourself. That's what I've had to learn, and I still haven't learned it, evidently. Because here I am, I remember what this speech bubble said, but I don't remember what these two were, at least entirely. I can assume this one was something like this. We'll figure that out. And I don't even freaking remember what I was doing here. So we'll have to TBD that one, but I think we can... I think I will do this page. Simply because the background should be fine. Should be more minimal, except for this last panel here. Yeah, this will be a fun page to do, I think. So let's do it, then. Enough talking about it, and then more doing it. This is a more finalized page. Since I got an influx of people having attention or eyes on what this will eventually look like. This isn't my favorite page. You know what, let me see if I have even a favorite page that I can open in case anybody even decides to be. It would probably be... maybe this one. Yeah, maybe that one. Honestly, the first page isn't bad, but I'm not really good at backgrounds, so maybe I'll hide that one for now. Honestly, one of my favorite pages might be in Chapter 1, which will be known as Chapter 2 in the future. Again, it's all very confusing. Okay. But I just needed to get the color for my bordars. Now, where is the paneling tool? There you are. Heal. A 3, and then 6 is the cutoff there. Oops, that's not what you want to do. And then we got this little thing here. Whoa, what the heck? Excuse me, panel, could you move? Resplit, thank you. Everything else seems to be in order. Except for this one existing, we gotta get you out of here. Be gone with you. Ah, doesn't the page just feel more open every time that happens? It's my favorite reason for doing that. Where do my rulers go every time I do that? 0 and whatever this is, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, this is 10, something by 7, 1, 2, 3, 8, so 1, 2, 3, 4, no, 3 and a half. Working out sizing here. And then we can do this fun little thing where you just steal what you had before. After all, it's not stealing if it's yours. I wonder if there's a situation in which you could steal from yourself. How would that even work? If you owned something and then took it from yourself and then it was still stealing. In some way, I wonder. I can't even fathom how I would steal from myself. It would have to be like you were deceived into doing it. Like if you thought you were robbing somebody, doing a sting operation with your criminal friends. Or not a sting. That would be getting caught, I believe, by the cops. And then your criminal buddy's like, nah, dude, I found this place, it's great, they got a huge stash or whatever. And then it turns out it was your stash the whole time and you just forgot, you didn't know it was yours. Then your criminal friend runs off with half of it. Anyway, that's the pilot for my next blockbuster movie. If y'all could pitch that to anyone you know in the industry, that'd be fantastic. You can tell them that my qualifications are almost having written part of a webcomic. Someday. Whoa, lasso, get back here. I'll lasso my lasso. Perspective shifting this would be interesting. Let's see. Ooh, not like that, I don't think. Well, maybe if we just distort it back into place. That's perhaps not what I wanted. Oh, that was what I wanted. Kind of? Oh, boy. I'll just fix it in post. Now, I used to use this sheet more often. I feel like I should do it more. This little facial reference thing here. Just to know what I'm working with. Thank you. music just keeps getting louder. Y'all gotta audio balance your music playlists on YouTube. Please. Just put one single limiter on it. One suppressor. Compressor? I don't know. I probably shouldn't say it like that either. That was a very weird inflection to use on that word. I think this ear needs to be more recessed. Ghost's hand is giving me trouble. It's what they normally do, though. That looks better. It only took that long. I spent like way too many minutes on that. Maybe hand studies are in order for warm-ups on dailies, I don't know. Took all my focus too, I wasn't even speaking that whole time. Couldn't risk it. What if I messed up the perfect line? Still working on it. Thank you. There's a few character designs that I think have shifted over the course of making this. For better or for worse, I do think this lad here, I think he's turning out better every time I draw him, which is nice. Well, I don't know if he's better or if I just find him more appealing to look at, which I guess, in terms of art, is kind of the same thing, because you're always trying to just generate appeal. Unless you're one of those artists on Instagram that draws creatures, in which case, you're probably just trying to gross people out. Which is also cool, you can do that. In fact, I admire the people who go that route, completely shirking the commonplace desire to want to draw something traditionally or conventionally attractive, and they're just like, oh, I'm drawing monstars, they look repulsive. Here you go. Take it or leave it. And there's an audience for that kind of stuff. I'm just not the kind of guy to draw my character with lots of goop and goo and pustules on them. And boils and what have you. Slime, scabs, all that gross protruding fangs and whatnot. At least not yet. I think I'll have to get used to drawing something like that. For the later parts of the comic, like, there's gonna be creatures in a fantasy story, of course, so I gotta figure that out at some point. The real question is, did I make his hair bigger? I think I might have. I'm kind of scared to verify. Because I think I already know the answer. I shouldn't be ashamed of it, but it's just, you know, maybe I could tone it back a bit. Not every character has to have large hair. If everyone has large hair, then nobody has large hair. You just start becoming blind to it. Ooh, New Ingress Adventuring Company page. I do read that one now, and by read, I mean I caught up to it. I'm all caught up on that one. So I guess I'm kind of officially its biggest fan now. That's kind of just how it works for me. Necks too long, foreheads too small. Those seem to be a couple of my main issues that I just seem to keep having until I adjust them. The fact that I can acknowledge them, though, is a step on the way towards progress and not making the mistakes anymore. But I've been making those mistakes for a long time, even though I know that I do it. And that's not even the full panel. I spent an hour on this. That's not true. I gotta be fair to myself. I did set up the panels, I suppose. So there's something. I'm super lurking while I get the 3D printer set up and lurk. Well, hello, a couple of lurkers sneaking in over there. You both freaking ran in the door at the same time. I just tripping over each other, I bet. When the hell did you get in? I've been focusing on this drawing for so long, I bet I've just been dead silent. Then a couple of miscreants made their way under my doorstep. And now I gotta get the rat poison out. Although I guess lurking is the chat equivalent of scurrying under my stove, but I'm not gonna move my stove right now. So you're safe for now. But hello, Steak and Halber, welcome in. Steak, I was just wondering where you were the other day. I was like, where is that guy? It's been a moment or two. Those were the exact words. Rude? What do you mean it's rude? I was worried about your well-being. Or are you talking about the rat poison? If it's about the rat poison, then yeah, that is... that was rude. Been keeping busy, going outside, touching grass, starting a new job, etc., etc. Ooh. Yeah, boring adult stuff and all that, but the change of scenery might be nice. I don't know what new job entails, but it's better than no job, as the news that could have showed up in chat. More meetings is all it means? Ah, well. I hold my stance. Better than no job. I like the money. Speaking of back to lurking, I had to hunt people down for work. Oh. Now, when you say meetings, did you mean to spell it M-E-A-T-I-N-G? Are you like... are you some kind of cannibal assassin? What's going on here? Because you could use your username as your spy codename or whatever, codename I mean. And you could be like Steak Bits, the cannibal assassin. And that would be pretty, that's all I'm saying. I know you're lurking, but I would like your thoughts on this as soon as possible. Doesn't have to be right now, but you know, just a comprehensive essay on pros and cons, maybe. I'll never do. That's true. Even if you were, you couldn't say it. So that's fine. You can never even know who in your family's a spy because they just won't tell you. It's like those wives and their husbands work in like black ops, very classified missions, and then sometimes in the middle of the night they just wake up and they leave, and you're not allowed to ask as the family member where they're going, because if they tell you, they'd have to kill you. It's a covert secret operation, lock and key. Even your most trust are not allowed to know, because then they become endangered. So you know, your husband just wakes up. Isn't this just Mr. and Mrs. Smith? I don't know, weren't they both in on it in Mr. and Mrs. Smith though? Also, probably yes. What a good movie. I gotta rewatch that. What is that on these days? Who owns the rights to that? That is on Hulu. Nice. Oh, they were both hiding it from each other. Okay, I get it. Yeah. This is just... Yeah, that's exactly what it is. No ideas are original anymore, okay? I tried my best, and what did I do? I came up with a movie plot from 2005. Someone's already thought about what you have thought of as original. God, I almost spent 2 hours on this one panel. Line art sucks, dude. People should just never paint anything. Do line art for anything. You can paint all you want. That's the solution, actually. It's already hard to draw this lady's little button-shaped nose here. At a normal scale, but now I gotta do it by the pixel? This is a nightmare. Why did I give her such a small nose? I mean, the answer is for character design variants, but... Even so, maybe I could have come up with anything easier? That's fine, this is better. We're in a spot. It's abstract enough to where you can interpret it and be like, yeah, that's a nose. That is nose, in fact. I've seen nose, and that is one of them. Alright, let's go back to the referents. What does her mouth do, I mean, look like? Okay, getting a better hand. I just gotta see. I've only drawn her so many times in this chapter here, so I gotta re-up myself. The nose ought to be higher than it is. I think we gotta schmoove the eyeballs over, or just one of them maybe? Thank you. Now I need this dang circle ruler all over the place. Hate it so much. How big were these, roughly? Well, that doesn't help me. It looks like they were small. Did I make them bigger over time? Maybe. That just seems to be how most things function on this comic. They just get bigger over time. That might be exciting news to some of you, but don't get ahead of yourself. This will not be a lewd series, I'll have you know. First of all, Webtoon would never allow that. Second of all, that's the only reason. No, it's not the only reason. If it was the only reason, I could just put it on my own website. I could host a website now that I have a Jorb. But I'm still not gonna do it. Let's add more hair, or at least make it seem more weighted on this side. A 3D printer, Halverson. I wonder what he's making. Probably downloading a car. You wouldn't download a car unless you totally could, in which case you definitely would. You could print that into your garage? Yeah, I would be doing that. Give me the CAD file immediately. I'm making a Chevy Cobalt. No, I'm not. Those are like probably like so bad. They just have a cool name, so I keep... That's why they stick in my brain. Alright, everybody, it's been literally 2 hours and we did one panel of line art. God, I'm good. Is there any wonder why I don't work at DC? It's all of the reasons. I'm wondering every day why I don't. Hire me. I'm so fast. Meet all your deadlines. I ran out of music. What? heck, dude? What the heck is this one? Beautiful Angel, Heroic Orchestral Music, The Power of Epic Music. Why do people make videos like this? Go to the Zelda radio. Just deciding which one I want to do next. Given what limited time I have on this world, no, I mean on this day of ours, the year of our Lord, 2023, September 28th. Plus side, this panel looks pretty good. This hand was very annoying. This probably took up like about 40 minutes of my time. Let's get that to look even how it does now, and here I am futzing around with it again. Futzing like a putz. Alright, what's her profile look like? I got it here. Let's, you know what, let's flip this so I can see. She'd be looking like this. It's probably the most helpful one here. Round, and then the lip. And a round chin. Hey, where did this little thing come from here? Where did this come from? There you are. What the heck is a circle doing here? Man, actually flipping this makes me realize I gotta go back and fix some stuff in in this chapter and in chapter 2. Just looking at it. Hey, what's this little thing over here? Yeah, I'll have to go touch up some stuff while I'm uploading those pages. Tell you, man, I've only been working on this comic for like, it might be like half a year in terms of the amount of months now, maybe a little over. But you improve a lot when you're drawing every day, to the point where you look at what you did recently and you're like, ew, that sucks. Why would I do it like that? And why does my husband keep leaving in the middle of the night? These lips even work. They go like that, they go inwards here. Now with the husband, I'd be sneaking out of bed, he'd cheese straight from the bag at 3 a.m. like a goblin. That's my marital secret. And your martial secret, because if they catch you doing that, you still gotta whoop them. That is a highly tense situation. If they catch you doing that, you do have to beat them up. That's just how it is. I'm sorry. You shouldn't have had to see this. And you snap them. That's not you snapping their neck, that's you snapping them a piece of the pretzel rod that you were eating, obviously. You can have some, just don't tell anyone, especially your parents. If the in-laws find out about it, it's over. Now, keep that pocket cheese on me. Now that you can't even tell your wife. You cannot tell your wife about the pocket cheese, otherwise, guess what? Number of wives you have, it goes down to this number. Maybe even like this number. Ooh. It'll be retroactively harder for you to get a new wife as a result of what you've done on that day. Alright, I should be drawing the hair on a different layer. Whoops! Rookie mistake. God dang it. I made the characters hot again. I feel like they just keep getting hotter, and I don't know what the problem... It's like not even... The problem is that I didn't start them off with these just because I've improved is the problem. And now they just look more attractive than they did before, which wouldn't be an issue normally, but now it's inconsistent and it's causing a continuity error. Especially since I'm drawing this whole chapter, I'm gesturing to the entire page here. Before the first chapter I drew, so the artistic skill is going to go backwards for a bit when I start uploading chapter 2, because I started working on it first. So I don't know how the heck this is gonna go. Artists or degens just accept it. Yeah, but like the thing is, if I hook him in with my amazingly fantastic, like I would say perfect character designs that I'm drawing here. And then the artistic skill goes downwards as they proceed. I don't know what that's gonna happen. Start them hot and you won't have a problem. Yeah, I guess, you know, that's how you should do it. When you're planning on making a webcomic, don't release the first chapter. Release the eighth chapter. And then by the time you get, you work backwards to the first chapter and start people off, you'll be so good that it'll be your new hook. And they won't even care that by the time they get to chapter 8, it looks like you did it when you were 16. That's an interesting strategy. I've never considered this before. Just hook them and then become worse over time. It would be like if Yusuke Murata, the One Punch Man manga guy, started off making the chapters, and then you got one to start doing them, and it was all part of the same thing. And then that just drop in quality was very apparent. But, like, you're hooked on the story now, so what are you going to do, stop reading? No, you won't. You're stuck here now. Although, that's for the manga crowd. Manga crowd definitely gets more invested in stories when compared to, say, the webtoon crowd. Let me tell you, the webtoon crowd, they are fickle beasts. Those ones, these freaking 14-year-old girls, they are picky, dude. And that's not me making this up, either. There's a story called Not Even... It's called Not Even Bones, I'm pretty sure. And, like, the only thing people are talking about on that series, regardless of the story stuff and what happens, is just the art style changed and looks slightly worse from season 1 to season 2. But the amount they talk about it, you would think they killed someone and brought in a new artist under slavery. Because that's all they talk about, and it must be, like, the most important event in the century. The art got slightly worse? Oh my god. Why are we even reading it anymore? Gotta make them Bishi character, that's true. Inuyasha thrived off of that. Considering that literally has no story, except for characters looking Bishi occasionally. The most popular characters in Yu Yu Hakusho, they got that shoujo eyes look. The big beautiful men. With their big beautiful eyes and their muscles. Internet's a tough crowd, yeah. Especially teenagers, man. I can't believe I'm posting on a platform inhabited largely by them. Isn't there a website that I can post to, or I can post my account, where there's just a bunch of 23-year-old dudes named Zotan? Who like fantasy stuff. That would be cool. Where's that place at? Where is Zotan.com? See your profile earlier in the chapter again. Alright, so it looks pretty similar to what I'm doing right now. Pay me enough, I'll like whatever you want. I'm not paying for Steak Bits advertisement, although that does seem like a very lucrative opportunity for me. It's simply not in my budget. How many dollars do I gotta give you, Steak Bits, for one Instagram reel? Like a true influencer marketer. How many followers you got? A couple million? You're right up there with Selena Gomez, right? You're like top 1 percentile. You wanna make it big, you gotta grease some hands. I don't wanna put grease on nobody's hands. That's how you get kicked out of places. My dog and mom following me, so I'd say it's a good start. I think maybe a half-used coupon at Target. Yeah, maybe. Maybe that's a good deal. I'll look into it. You know, the hardest part of that transaction isn't even paying you. It's trying to find a Target coupon in the year 2023. An unused one, let alone a used one. Like, didn't Walmart just eat every Target in the world by now? Like, what's going on? Imagine being a big chain retailer when Walmart is already out there. Being Walmart. Could pay you in Andes mints. I do have a few of those lying around, unwrapped, in my pocket. Yo, say no more. I love Andes mints. They're pretty freaking good. God, it's hot in this room again. How does this always happen? It's always so cold in this house, and then I step into this room for about 10 seconds, and I'm dying. Must be some dang good insulation in here, preserving all the heat. I might as well live in a greenhouse in my main office here. Probably some of that good stuff, you know, some of that old insulation, you know, I probably got some asbestos in here keeping all the heat in. And the lead paint, forget about it. Nothing getting in or out. Radiation, brain cells, it's all staying in. Let's flip this, see where we are at here. Yeah, I figured this eye would need to be very quickly adjusted. think it has to do with the nose shape, actually. So I did download Monster Hunter now. I was trying to avoid it for a while, but it did eventually get to me. And this is how I know Google has no idea how to advertise, and it's a miracle to me that their main revenue stream is ads, because they have no idea how they function. This whole time, I was considering getting Monster Hunter Now. Not a single Monster Hunter Now ad, ever. At all. But the moment I download it and I have it and I'm playing it currently, a billion Monster Hunter Now ads. The Google Play Store knows that I downloaded it. I have it installed. Everything is linked to the same account, and yet now I'm getting the ads for the game that I just got. That's not normally where the point of the point of contact is supposed to happen when you're thinking about purchasing something. I'm just saying, I took a marketing class and you're supposed to, I think, tell people, or like suggest to them, that they should buy it before they do it, not after they do it. But that's just me, you know, I took one class, I'm not an expert or anything. I could be very wrong, but I would think, with my brain, that that's how it works. And that's the wrong pencil. Time is it? I got a bit more time. Might as well finish up this lady. No, that's wrong what I've done. Okay. Better. Wait, but I still need this one. I gotta put it over here. Hmm. much time? Maybe I could finish this guy. I don't know. I do gotta draw two eyes, which is always the most arduous form of art. When you've given yourself two eyes to draw on the same face. And I've done that. I seem to have done that. Make his neck thicker. He is a thick lad, this one. What a lucky woman. Look at the pectoral width on this gentleman here. Looking like freaking Kylo Ren over here. Just a wide torsoed man. It's also my favorite ZZ Top parody song. Girls go crazy for a wide chest man. Nobody should be here listening to my garbage. Thank goodness, most of the time, there's visuals on screen to make up for whatever the heck I'm doing. I treat my art and whatever I say as separate entities. It's for the best. This is why most artists don't stream. It's because if they did, people would realize how completely off the rails that they would have to become in order to try and stream while to talk about anything for an extended period of time. This has been mostly a silent stream, and what little input I've given in spite of that seems to most people, who are probably right, nonsensical. But no, but it's like the best I got. And the only thing I got is my stream of conscience. Sometimes. It's hard to put everything into the void constantly. What do you want from me? Money? I don't have any. Not for you. I have Andy's mints. I give them to anybody who needs something. Homeless people? You give them money, they could just spend it on booze or drugs. You give them an Andy's mint, you know where that's going. right in their mouth. Looks a little skewed. In a sick and twisted kind of way. Let's fix that. Transform skew. And think we got to adjust the head tilt a wee bit, and then it should be mostly fine. If I don't press the Windows key. Cancel this. Gotta get rid of all the line art here. Oh, what the heck layer are you on? Okay, this one. We just might be able to finish this panel here in time for me to go to bed at a reasonable hour. Which I know might not seem high stakes to you guys, but for me that is the most important thing in the world today. To me, it is perfect. Yeah, also, there's a new Drawfee episode out today. I freaking forgot. Now I have to go watch that before I go to bed. I'm gonna eat up even more of my time. God, there's just so many things I have to do. That Twitter thinking that I like Ruby again? Nope. Thank goodness. I might have finally escaped the hole. Would you like to see Weiss and Ruby shipped again for the 80th time, having never seen a second of the source material?
No.
Frankly, I'm sick of this. I don't know who they are. I don't know why I should care. Get them away from me. Believe it or not, it does take more than the idea of two girls kissing to get me interested in a series. Not a lot more, but like a little more at least, you know, like something. I can do with more shipping. You can do with more shipping. Have you not been watching anything created past the year 2015? It's like all shows live on these days. And then you got the complainers out there. Can we stop shipping every character couple that shows up on screen? It's destroying and devaluing the idea of platonic relationships. I know it's not. Let people freak out over the fictional characters, maybe or maybe not hand-holding, alright? Was that a blush on frame 37 in the minute 18 of episode 8? I don't know, it could have been. Everybody hyperanalyze. It's a little ambiguous, there's lighting and shadow all over the frame. The composition is not clear. You know, let people do that. Is that what these videos are about? What do you mean? Which videos? Which videos are you watching or talking about or both? Shipping vids, are they just over analysis about characters possibly handholding? I mean, sometimes, yeah, but other times it is them breaking down their character arcs and saying why they should be with each other. Because I'm going to go ruin my YouTube recommendations. Yeah, some of the videos are like that for sure. If you're looking for that kind of content. Someone lists, like, see, there's a ton of reaction YouTubers as well. They do YouTube shorts and they just have copyrighted content in their little box in the bottom left corner. And they're just like, and then it's just like, you know, did the characters almost kiss? Maybe they should. A lot of fangirling, a lot of fanboying, fanning in general. Sounds like horrible content. It is, and I've seen more than one of those. They just react to, usually, animated shows, because as you would imagine, that's where shipping content is the most, what is it? What is the word? The most prolific, the most widespread, the most propagated, perhaps? It's awful content. Every time it shows up in my YouTube Shorts page, I'm like, how did I even get... I don't like any of this. How did this show up? I don't normally have to worry about shipping content because I'm more of a canonical shipper type kind of guy, which is like, if they're canonically already together, then I will hyperfixate on all the fan art and be like, oh my god, these two are perfect. They are adorable together, and they deserve the world. But I don't like pairing people in if the show hasn't paired them itself. That's like a weird thing about me. I don't like it. I don't like doing it. I just don't like envisioning people together if they're not already together. That's just how I function. So you're saying two characters existing in the same room isn't reason enough for you to imagine them going to town on each other? No, not usually. Otherwise, watching stuff like Family Guy would be a whole ordeal, and I don't even watch it already, so. Now, watching it with that in mind, I don't think I could stomach an episode. Especially considering they have that art style, which is, I don't know, man, You know, some people are into that art style, like in that way. I don't know how you do that. How does your brain get that wire crossed in that particular way? Where you're like, the Family Guy art style? Oh, absolutely. I get down with that every Friday night. It's so not good for that. It's really not. Or like, imagine being the person whose brain is like Bob's Burgers. Mm-hmm. Yep. That's what I need. This is what I needed today. Please stop. I'm just... You can't kill the messenger. To carry these thoughts to their conclusion in my mind. I'm just the messenger. What you choose to do with the information is not up to me. Now, when you say to their conclusion... Commission you to try these horrible, horrible things. I'll have you know I have the right to deny anything you say just because you offer me a commission. Doesn't mean I have to draw your horrible punishments. I am not contractually beholden to you. You're not my boss. You could be. It would just cost a lot. I'll just keep sending you overly detailed descriptions of what I want. No, you should do the opposite. You should send me, like, very piecemeal descriptions. You're gonna be like, alright, so what I want you to draw, I want you to draw this vague ovular shape here. And then draw, like, a downwards balloon. And then draw, like, a really thick mustache. And then put the name of the character over here. It's B, and then the second letter's O, and then the last one's B. And then you should do it one step at a time until it's too late for me to even realize what you've done to me. By that point, I will have already drawn Bob in whatever compromising circumstance you would have wanted. And I wouldn't even know. It was too vague. I couldn't have seen it coming. Until you do take one. And then you should just throw it into an AI art generator, because that's what everyone's doing anyway. Actually, I think the AI art generators are explicitly not allowed to do explicit art. So that's probably the bad suggestion, but it's good that it can't. It's good that it's a bad suggestion, is what I should say. I like how that was the one ethical high road that all these AI art generators decided to take. You can't draw nudes. Haha, get owned. It's like, why would you... So theft on an international level. Across millions, hundreds of thousands of artists all over the world. That's fine. But you're not gonna let people draw nudes with your AI art generator? What's wrong with you? What are you talking about? Right? I don't get where the line is. As discussed earlier, meetings, yay, catch you later. Thanks for stopping in, Stay. I'll be ending probably literally about right now, so, you know, good timing. Catch you later, mate. This comic is coming along, I will say, since I decided to abandon that monologue earlier. Start working on something else until I figure it out. Okay. And with that, thank y'all for stopping by. Halber for the lurk, if you're still here. And anyone else who comes along in the future. Yep, more comic stuff tomorrow, as per usual. And I guess that's it. Thanks for all the recent, pardon me, follows from Swanstream the other day. If you're liable to hear this at all, at any point. If not, I'll just say it again when you show up in the future. I'll remember, maybe. But yeah, bye-bye.